Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. We are in the Calm, and we're going to head to the Daughter's Fathom, if at all possible. Because we have some... Well, we have a quest. Right, so we're supposed to find these women. We found two more. Kiwatawa, a member of the Dendro Ahur, and Avina, a young girl who lives in Cliff's Edge. She drove it out of her mind, the ghost's voice, by sheer force of will. She's the one who plays the flute. Sorry about that. Hit the mic. So we're supposed to return to the labyrinth and tell her. We found these women. I don't know if we found all of them.
Of course.
Empty reflection? Hail. A woman-shaped hole in the air stands before you. This guy floats up. Her palms outstretch and you sense something different. A smell. If emotions could smell, it is sharp confusion and a sense of displacement. Somehow this woman's shade knows she does not belong here in your mind. Yeah, I kind of know that too. Okay, she's trying to take over my mind with whispers too? Is this the ghost lady?
I'll remember that.
Oh, says the specter, strolling up beside you. A reflection from a different cast-off, isn't it? He studies the outlines, outstretched hands. She's lost something, he says after a moment. Something out in the world that she misplaced, or was taken from her. If you want to draw her here, you'll have to find it. You turn back to the woman-shaped void. She continues to face you, hands held out imploringly, ignoring the specter completely. It's like she's a me-shaped black hole. Who are you? I'm going to do the puzzle box, I think. You fancy that you hear your words echoing in the dark, hollow space within the woman-shaped outline, and someone very distantly calling back. I don't think she can hear you, the specter says. For that matter, I don't think it's even a she right now. She's more of a placeholder than a person. An arrow pointing somewhere else in a labyrinth. He peers cautiously into the outline in the air as though it is a long and potentially dangerous tunnel. You'll need to find out what she's missing before you can bring her forward. And you won't find it here, I think. Can you hear me? This time you hear no response. Hello? What is it that you want? For a second, another outline flickers in her outstretched hands, a box or cube-like shape. Then it is gone and doesn't return, right? She wants the puzzle box. Okay. If you want Cenobites, this is how you get Cenobites. Okay, you can solve the thing. Just let me get the hell out of here first. I don't want to explore the, you know, the further regions of existence. At least, not those ones. Here's a puzzle box.
I'll remember that.
You gently place the cube in the shadowed figure's hands. They close over it, and a young woman, the one you found dead in the ruins of the house, plunges toward you out of the darkness, filling the outline until the outline is her. She nearly stumbles into you before she stops herself, blinking hard. Ouch, she says. You notice that the box you gave her is now as ghostly as she is. I hate giving up items, but we did it. Well done, the specter says, turning away from the stunned woman. I'll give you two some time to talk. You turn to the young woman again. She glances at the darkness above you, and something about the expression reminds you of someone. Of course, the ghostly woman in the fifth eye. I was reminded the second I saw that thing. Who are you? Saria, she says. You remember me. You found me beneath the chunks of my adopted father's house with my gut smashed to paste. Who is your adoptive father? Orciolo. He was one of you, she says carelessly. A cast-off, I mean. A frown creases her forehead. Poor old man. He never wanted to be special. He found me, fed me, talked to me when I was, you know, troubled. But when the house fell on me, I guess he couldn't stand it. And he went looking for a way to die.
Making a note.
She falls silent, but you don't need to be told what happened next. You've seen the statue, after all. It was grief that drove Orseolo to seek death in Asara's arms. Seria watches you, eyes shining with some inner light. I'm sorry that this happened to you.
I'll remember that.
Gold? Tiny amount? Don't be. He tried to help me, but my life wasn't so wonderful. I was always confused. She sweeps the hair from her eyes. I had a voice in my mind, a woman, telling me I was supposed to be her. Orseolo tried, so hard, to make me feel better, to talk to me when it was really bad. She smiles sadly. But I think he knew it couldn't last, she says, her smile fading. He was afraid, but not for himself. He believed, no, knew I was going to die. One time he said he'd seen me die too many times, then shut himself up. She claps a hand to her mouth, lowers it. Like that. She shrugs. But he wasn't wrong, was he? Even if he was a little crazy to begin with. No, he wasn't wrong. But you're here now. She nods moodily. Sort of. I'm not really me, though. I'm a reflection of what my father saw of me. The only piece of his mind that's left. Wow, that's like so sad. When he died, his part of the labyrinth, well, I want to say it broke, but it was worse than that. The cracks burst up through the ground and everything started crumbling. I could feel parts of him slipping away, snapping off. She shudders. I'm glad you brought me here. I would have fallen apart eventually, and then there'd be nothing of him left. Nothing of either of us. What does that puzzle box mean to you? My father gave it to me, she says, beaming down at the ghostly version of the box in her hands. He said it was a very old puzzle, and solving it would help me. I never did, but fumbling with it made me feel better. I always had the feeling that the pictures on it might mean something, but that was as far as I got. Do you know anything else about Orseolo? I should, shouldn't I? I was part of his mind, after all. She passes a hand over her forehead absently, leaving her ghostly eyebrows completely disheveled. But no, if I focus, I can see the other women he took care of. The ones that look like me. I mean, but it's like looking through dirty glass. I think that means he didn't want me to think about them. Or couldn't. She shrugs, looking away. I don't know why he spent all that time caring for us. I guess I'll never know for sure now, but... All right, one time I asked him what his tattoo meant. Atonement, he said. But not, you know, dramatically. He said it like he was saying his name. Like... She pauses, rubbing her forehead again. Like it was everything he was. Like if he couldn't atone for, you know, whatever it was, there was no reason to exist anymore. But I don't know why he started, and I'll never get a chance to ask him. Grinning again, she rolls her eyes. And that's it. That's all I know about the man who raised me for years. Kids, huh? A creature named the Sorrow killed Orseolo. Do you have any idea how it found him? No, she says, staring at the air, thinking. He didn't abuse his power like some of you do. Didn't pull against the tides or use them as weapons. He never wanted to be noticed, to be found. Didn't matter, did it? Who are you again? Seria, she says, rolling her eyes. Dead girl in the broken house. I know you have a lot on your mind, but come on. What are you again? A reflection from Orseolo's mind. The only one that's left. I'll be here. You know, in your head. And she is. You abruptly feel her presence inside your mind as if she's always been there. A new weight behind your temples. Ooh, we got a new ability? Something has happened on an instinctual level. You've established a bond with this reflection. Some of her gifts are yours, and you feel stronger for it. However, this link fully occupies a corner of your mind. You may be able to forge connections with more than one reflection in the labyrinth, but not many. So we've got Seria's piece. She idly flexes her transparent hands, humming a halting, tuneless little melody under her breath. The connection between you pulses with the rhythm of her song. I like your mind, the young woman says, peering around. Nice high ceilings. I don't think there is a ceiling. She waves goodbye. Actually... Oops. I can get there from there. Wait. Character sheet. I think it's C, but... Serious Peace. Plus one might, plus one speed, plus one intellect. Serious calming music fills you, strengthening you in every way. So we can have, like, a few of these. Or a couple. But, we choose which ones we want. And if we don't want this one, if we find something better, which this is pretty neat by itself, it's cool to have plus four in these now. We're gaining a lot of stat increases. I'm guessing we're going to need them. But anyway, if you find something better and you have too many connections, you can break your connection. I don't know if you can get it back after that.
I'm going.
Let's head to the daughter's...
On it.
The portal has collapsed into this tiny pulsing sphere. Something about it strikes you as angry, though you'd be hard-pressed to say why. It's the daughter's Fathom.
Of course.
So we're gonna talk to her. I'm assuming. So I wonder if we can continue on now that we found, you know, more of them.
Fine.
Ghostly woman. Oh, Kia Tower's over here. Oh, it's opening up. I see it. Ghostly woman's eyes grow wide at the scene in front of you. That's me. I remember now. The siege ended, the Tabat were driven back, and I was among the survivors, but she places her hand on the surface of the chamber. I didn't exactly survive. One of the Tabat's weapons made me sick somehow, in my mind. My father was an explorer and a tinkerer. He knew something about my Numenera, about the Numenera. He put me in there to protect me. But the Aeon priests and the Chirurgeons couldn't help me. No one could. My father kept me in stasis until a cure could be found. She gazes into the distance, as though trying to remember something. Are the women the result of some attempted cure? I don't know. Please, we're so close. Keep looking so we can find the answer. She looks so real. Her chest moves up and down with each breath. It's strange to see the ghostly woman both inside the chamber and out of it. You know, I'm not sure. I thought she was moving a little bit, but I don't think so. So wait. She went back over here then. Have you found any more of the women? We have to help them. Let's recap. Can you tell me about the siege again? Tabat were everywhere. So many people died. I remember their screams. It's a miracle Sagus Clef survived. What about the stasis chamber? After the siege, I became very sick. My father didn't know what to do, so he put me into stasis until a cure could be found. Do you have any more impressions of where I might find these women? I know that one of them is a leader. She has sacrificed much of her life, and so gained life in return. She shakes her head as though to clear it. I'm sorry I can't tell you more than that. Don't forget, we must know more.
On it.
These machines make no sounds or motion at all. Like the other machines here, they seem to be just a facade. There's nothing else we can look at.
I'm ready.
The air is warm next to this machine, and you feel dizzy whenever you go near it. So I feel dizzy now, then. There's Avena. And the ghostly woman. A translucent man appears. He is unfamiliar to you, but he seems to be working on the machine. The ghostly woman watches him, her brow furrowed. I know him. The engine, it's... What is he doing? He's trying to save me. I think he's my father. She tilts her head. The memories of this place must be fuzzy. He doesn't look right, but he feels right. I'm certain it's him. She reaches out for the translucent figure, but her hand goes right through him. She calls out, Father? Father! The man continues his work as though she weren't there. The ghostly woman sags, I'm invisible to him. You! She places a solid hand on your shoulder, her eyes suddenly lit. He used that machine, that probability engine, to recreate me and other women. This machine is but a memory, but the engine exists in the real world. I know it. She looks at the ghostly man. Speak to him. Find out how to shut it off. Then you can do the same in the real world and end this.
Updated my journal.
Updated my journal. So who's here then? Sari is there. Speak to my father. We have to know how to shut off these engines. Can you tell me about that man again? He's my father. At least I'm pretty sure he is. He doesn't look right, but he definitely feels like my father. What about the machine? It's called a probability engine. Somehow my father figured out enough to turn it on, and now he's forcing me into women all over the city. Hmm. So somewhere in the real world, in the ninth world, he is actually doing this, I'm guessing. Or he's going to do it. Or he already did it. Doesn't matter. He's here. Figure out how to turn out the machine from him and we can end this now. Talk to my father. Make him understand. Alright. The ghostly woman's father works frantically, turning dials, stripping metal wires, attaching and detaching various pieces within the machine. After each change, he places a hand on the side of the machine, speaks some words and gestures in the air. He doesn't seem to notice you at all. Can I help you? No, he says, but he doesn't appear to be speaking to you. That's not right. Her hair was softer, thinner, her eyes more like caramel. He's not speaking to me. He's talking to himself. He speaks to the machine again, swipes through the air rapidly, then sticks his hands inside the engine and rearranges several delicate parts. I need to know how to turn the machine off. What? He whirls around, his eyes bright with fury. Turn it off? That would kill her. Kill her, do you understand? I'm so close to bringing her back. It's just a matter of tuning the machine correctly. His face darkens. I won't shut it down, and you will not force me. Although he makes no signal or gesture, the Tabat soldiers from the other side of the Fathom run to his aid. Somehow this ghostly construct's anger has summoned them. Oh no. I have no allies here. Fight with me, ghostly women. Leave! The platform rumbles with the power and pain of his cry. Leave me alone. You will not take what's left of my daughter from me. Something's wrong with the machine, though. It's hurting people. He waves you off. Bah! You're guessing. You don't know the side effects any more than I do. But I do know this will bring her back to me. Now leave, or I will force you to leave. Let's see if I can do this without attacking. Alright, I won't force you. Farewell. You can't force me. They're leaving. He won't tell me how to shut it off without a fight. Maybe if you can find more women, I might be able to remember more. But we don't even know if there are more. She looks at the memory of her father. He's not real. You won't hurt them. If fighting will stop the injustice that engine has caused, then maybe that's what must be done. Well, I'm assuming they will hurt me,
Let's go.
How about, what's her name over here? Saria. And the ghostly woman keeps appearing near where the, okay, the new ghost is. The machines and the stasis chamber are transformed into shattered, smoking wrecks. The ghostly woman laughs, the first time you've heard her do so, though the humor in it is dubious. I died. I remember it now. I never survived the stasis chamber, and the probability engines were his vain attempt to resurrect me.
Making a note.
She looks sadly at the translucent man representing her father. He doesn't know. He thinks he can save me, but he's lost me forever. Tell him. Tell him he could never get me back. Not the real me. Can you tell me about your death again? I don't remember what happened, only that I died in stasis, wholly and completely. I don't know why he thought he could bring me back. Well, maybe now he will understand. Whatever caused this destruction did an extremely thorough job of it. What's left of the woman inside is unrecognizable and smells too real for your taste. Charred ghost woman.
All right.
So maybe now he will listen to reason? I wouldn't be surprised if he doesn't, though. Hopefully he doesn't make me fight these things by myself. And my companions are not here with me. This ghostly father continues to work frantically at the machine as though he were operating on his actual child. And who's that? The ghostly woman? I'd really like to help you. He continues his work, completely oblivious to you. You have to tell me how to shut down the machine. His face darkens. I won't shut it down, and you will not force me. Once again, the labyrinth constructs of the Tabat run to his aid. Leave. The platform rumbles with the power and pain of his cry. Leave me alone. You will not take what's left of my daughter from me. Now I could look for the other one, who's a leader of some kind. A leader woman? Could be any one of a number of people. Well, let's try some persuasion and see what happens. Don't you understand? Your real daughter is dead. Even with the machine, you can never truly have her back. All the way. Yes. No, my daughter is... He starts to point at the ghostly woman, then takes a closer look at her. Are you truly dead? I am not your daughter. She is gone forever. He looks between you and her, despair growing on his face. Finally, his shoulders sag.
I'll remember that.
Despondently, he says, watch. He places his hand on the side of the engine and says the word Neshu. Suddenly, a glowing interface appears in the air. He presses 5 symbols in a specific sequence. He performs the ritual a second time, and then the machine grows quiet and dim. The ghostly man begins to fade. To the woman, he says, I only wanted to set things right. Then he is gone. He told you how to shut off his engines. Go! Turn them off before it gets any worse. Where do I find the probability engine in the real world?
Making a note.
I don't know, but it looks like that, I'm sure of it. She points to the probability engine nearby. Keep looking. I know it's there somewhere. It must be hidden if it's still doing its work. Look underneath the city. There are thousands of buried secrets there. I know, we just came from there. The buried crossroads. It looks like that. Farewell. Stop the machine. Whatever it takes. I don't suppose there's anything new to see.
Fine.
Alright, let's go. Pretty interesting. I like this. This story is pretty awesome. Okay, so that's back to the Ninth World. Hopefully I don't get attacked by the Sorrow.
I'm going.
I don't suppose Sarah will have anything new to say. I like your mind.
All right.
What's on your mind? Get it?
I'm going.
Going back. If I go back to where we were, so I have to travel all the way back. Yeah, looks like we are. Awesome. Oh. What's up, guys? I'm back.
Enough dawdling. We have a world to see.
That looks like the engine.
I'm going.
Yeah. Here's the interface. Right? It's gotta be it. Yep. Wires and cables extend from this device into the rock wall. Turn the probability engines off. You speak the word Neshu, and the interface brightens. You press the same five symbols you saw the ghostly man use in the labyrinth. You're about to repeat the ritual a second time as he did, but you meet resistance of some kind. Your hands simply won't obey. It's not a physical resistance. Something in your mind won't let you complete the sequence. Concentration, tidal affinity. Fight off the resistance, whatever it is.
I'll remember that.
Cool. We get some experience. It takes an incredible strength of will, as though some other mind were fighting for control of your body. Ghostly woman? Or the father? Finally, you overcome it, entering a sequence a second time. The interface appears and disappears, and the machine quiets. It is done. That woman, Calistri says, all those variegated versions of her, you have put an end to them. Why did you do that? And she thinks, I'm not so different. What if my copies, if I, were so easy to shut down? What do you really want to ask me, Calistese? What indeed? She takes a deep breath and lets it out slowly. It could be said that she and I are similar. If I were one day to become as fragmented, a poor facsimile of the person you had known, what would you do? I would find a way to speak with the real you, to determine your wishes. Gold tired, small amount. Ha! The real me! Why, dear, you would hardly know where to begin. The real me is me. And so my sisters would claim, each in their turn. Despite her words, her smile is genuine. Consider my curiosity sated. Okay, so hopefully you'll like me a little bit more now that I didn't give you the book. Ah, speaking of which. You wanted the Changing God's notes on the datasphere? Here, take them. She turns it over in her hands, examining every inch of the binding. Your sire always has such marvelous craftsmanship, she murmurs, slowly releasing the drawstring that binds it closed. As she flips through the pages, slowly at first, then faster, you catch sight of diagrams, notations, and drawings, all of them of your sire's machines beneath the city of Sagas. Thank you. Calistis breathes without looking up and moves away to continue her study of the book's contents. Yes, yes, interesting. She catches you looking at her. His observations on the datasphere are fascinating. Nothing I can share yet. It's purely conjecture. She thinks, this could be what I've been looking for. Even so, please be careful. Accessing the full unrestrained data sphere might be dangerous for you. Goldtide. She follows a quick glance at you with a scoff. Dangerous? Surely not. Perception check. As she turns away from you, she starts riffling through the pages as if verifying her statement. Two of her echoes whisper to her, worried looks on their faces. She dismisses them with a wave of her hand, but sinks deep into contemplation. I hope she knows what she's doing. I love the way this reflects like this, actually. Those things are freaky looking. It's like you could see all their organs in there. Like the science dummies. She raises an eyebrow and waits. Tell me again how you're feeling. When two great minds complement each other, there's nothing that can't be accomplished. So it is with you and I. I already asked her those questions. Oh, I think it's between us. Great, he declares, throwing his hands in the air. I knew we had the same instincts for adventure. Can't you tell me anything about the voices I keep hearing in your head? If you're hearing voices, that sounds like your problem, not mine. Seriously, what is that glow surrounding you? What glow? Tiber?
Yes, lass?
How you holding up? I'm fine, lass. I just hope you won't regret our friendship when the time comes to part ways. He stretches. Why would I regret friendship? Alright, let's check out these mirrors again. You have one last thing to do. Use a thin mirror to kill yourself again, huh? Let me just look at something. I want to look at these things. As we can't search them. They're not going to have, like, gold or stuff on them. Wait, do we know what this thing is yet? Nothing new. Let's turn it back on. Machine is dim and silent now.
Absolutely.
Pretty nasty looking. Alright, yeah. Nothing else to do. I really like the reflection, it's pretty cool. Look at the purple glow in the side mirror again and allow it to carry you through the opposing mirror. A flood of purple light streams from the mirror as soon as you look at it. It lifts you from your feet and carries you into the mirror on the other side. Whoa. Where are we gonna be? In Circus Minor now? Greetings. Matt Keena. And where the hell is she? Well, while we're here, let's just sleep.
Never get enough.
The messenger again. I don't know. I don't know where Makina is. The footsteps of Folsom's messenger draw you from your sleep. Yeah. Her clothes are disheveled as though she was shoved from a comfortable bed to go looking for you. Well, at least now she got some sleep before she just, like, pulled an all-nighter, I guess. There's been another murder. A couple of our boys spotted the killer, but she got away and fled the city. She rubs her eyes. The big man wants to see you. She thinks, glad I ain't her right now. Fled the city. Could that be Makina? Fled the city? I'm gonna keep going. I don't know.
At last.
Who got killed this time? I figured we'd find Makina. He winks. And he nods. Winking and nod. Okay, we've seen that one. He spits, it's nice.
Heretus, a curious thought occurred to me. You know I've warned
you. I told you, I won't speak to you whilst you have her in tow. If you want to talk so badly, ditch her first.
Until then, peddle yourself somewhere else. So who died this time? I don't like it here. I didn't choose to come here. Your bloom stole me from my world. You still have to check that out. He groans. Give the big man some space. Alright, who died?